Hey, I don't come cheap, Eddie. You have to talk to my agent, right?
Each one of you with us this morning. We want to move right into the program, and if you got a bulletin, then we have a schedule of the service in there this morning. And Norma has taken some time and worked with the children, and she has a skit this morning that she'd like to present to us. I'll ask her to come up this morning.
People have been straight up. Now the workers and carpenters. We will be able to repair guys.
Thank you.
say I waited 4 months to be able to, or almost 4 months to be able to hear what Angela said there. We're finished now. I was glad to hear that.
Yes.
Glad that we're back in the building.
Amen.
It took us a little longer than we anticipated to begin with. And as I watched this crew of partners that she had working for her up here, I realized why it took us a long. We didn't have them. I didn't see them out here working and helping us out. But if we'd have had them working with us, we would have probably finished a little quicker. But it's good to have you with us this morning. We appreciate you being in the service with us. We had some visitors for Sunday school. I just want to mention those that have come to, that came to visit with us for Sunday school. Lauren Harris, Noah Harris, Becky Michaels, Tanya Harris, James Lewis, Joe and Joyce Roberts, Sherry and Logan Crawford, John and Denise Terry.
I know he has these.
Aren't you ever going to come home? And, I appreciate my wife. patients during this building program, and helping out with some food and doing some cooking for us, a few days there. Appreciate all that you did. As a pastor, there's a lot of times that you experience joys that are somewhat different than you would in other areas of life, or other locations. And I have experienced those over the years. But I just wanted to share just a moment of the joys that I've received being able to be a pastor Wednesday nights after the service, not after all of you had, or those of you that were here had already left to go home. A young man, about 18 years old, that stood around, waited around for a while. And finally he said, "Mr. Ernst," he said, "can I talk to you?" I said, "Sure." And at that time, I was in the fellowship hall, so we walked up to the church. We had a talk, and we prayed, and he got saved. And I just really appreciate Mr. Ernst. And he has been somewhat like one of our own. He finds his place at our table every time he comes in with our boys, and with Randy especially. And I just really appreciate the rest of his money. It's my privilege to be able to pray with him Wednesday night. All right. Bob, everyone else wants to bring us a special song. good to have our district superintendent and his wife with us, Mr. Garber. And Mr. Garber is going to bring a message for us this morning. I'll ask him to come.
Well, I'm here to congratulate you on this beautiful enlarged sanctuary and the remodeling. It's beautiful. I'm excited. We're here to celebrate.
Amen.
Are you in the mood to celebrate?
Amen.
I believe you are. Didn't you enjoy the children?
Amen.
So appropriate on Palm Sunday when, as you know, the children were in the crowd and sang, Hosanna, Hosanna. And that's beautiful, wonderful, special music. Your pastor has certainly arranged an appropriate and wonderful service on this historic day in the Anniston Church of the Nazarene. I want to commend your pastor and the congregation, your church board, building committee, builder, and all. Commend you for your vision. Amen? Your vision, your faith, and your sacrifice. Because this building project, this step of progress has been possible because so many people have been willing to sacrifice to give above your tithes and offerings, I'm sure, to enable this to be possible. So you certainly are to be commended. My text for today is found in the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 2. Time to look that scripture up. Isaiah chapter 54, verse 2, and the first part of verse 3. Enlarge the place of thy tent. Enlarge the place of thy tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of thine habitations. Spare not. Don't hold back, what one translation says. Spare not. Lengthen thy cords, and strengthen thy stakes. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles and make the desolate to be inhabited. Notice in verse 1, sing, O barren, sing. And that's what we're doing today. We're singing and shouting and praising the Lord for his divine help. The Living Bible, paraphrased, translates this verse, Isaiah 54:2, as follows. Enlarge your tent. Build on additions. That's the way it's translated. Build on additions. Spread out. For you will soon be bursting at the seams. Amen? For you will soon be bursting at the seams, Pastor, congregation. This text, which was written over 700 years before Christ in Isaiah's day, this text is a description of the Anniston Church of the Nazarene. The New International Version reads, you will spread out to the right and to the left. This text is a description of a growing church. Today is a day of celebration of the growth of your church, but more important than enlarging your sanctuary is the increasing of your congregation. It's the people that are more important than the building. Key words in this text. Enlarge thy tent. Stretch forth, lengthen thy cords, strengthen thy stakes, break forth. forth on the right, break forth on the left. Don't hold back. Spare not. Expand. Enlarge. You like those words? Amen. That, to me, is what has been happening in your Anniston church. But the best translation of all that I like was in the Living Bible, build on additions. For you will soon be bursting at the seams. I like that, don't you? Now back to the text. Enlarge thy tent. Isaiah here is referring back to the first tent tabernacle. He's calling their memories back to the very first sanctuary, which was a tent tabernacle built by Moses. When God said to Moses, here are the children of Israel that are going across the desert toward Canaan land, and God said to Moses, let them make me a sanctuary. Let them make me a sanctuary that I may dwell among them. Now, this first place of worship, this very first sanctuary mentioned in the Bible, was made of the skins of animals. Ram skins, badger skins. It was a tent tabernacle, a tent sanctuary, a place of worship. But it was God's dwelling place, and a tent is a tabernacle and God is in it. Amen? So as Isaiah reminded Israel of the first tent tabernacle in their past history, so today it is a good day for the Anniston Church of the Nazarene to remember and celebrate the victories of the past. The first Anniston sanctuary was not a tent. Now it may have been a tent, it may be, as many churches started, it may have started with a tent revival. I don't know that, some of you that are here. But the first building was, the first place of worship was in a small building located at 24th and Noble Streets. Y'all remember the beginning of the church in this small building? There was a small congregation, only five families. That was back in 1944. Any charter members here today that were there worshiping in that first building? If so, stand up. Anyone? What year? Grace Roberts? Stand up. Give her a hand. That first building. Any charter members here today? You stand up. All right. But the first time that the Anniston Church enlarged its tents was in 1958 under the pastoral leadership of Reverend Aubrey Martin. And this present location, where this building is, was purchased here on Sachs Road. And there was a new sanctuary that was enlarging the tent. And there were Sunday school facilities. So this was a giant step in the continued growth of the church. And it's interesting that the first service in this first new sanctuary was on Easter Sunday. This is Palm Sunday, so we're almost celebrating again the new sanctuary that was built here on this property. Now, the second time that the church enlarged its tents was under the pastoral leadership of Reverend J.T. Rushing, when they erected a parsonage, which then, the basement of the parsonage became the fellowship hall, or the place for fellowship. And then the third time that the church enlarged its tents was under the pastoral leadership of Reverend Jimmy Ernest, Jimmy and Ethel. That was the erection of your present new fellowship hall building, which then also made more room to grow with Sunday school facilities, children's worship, and etc. Then the fourth time the church enlarged its tent, making history today, today is a historic day in the church. We celebrate. Today we celebrate another milestone in the growth and progress of your church. So, today let's celebrate. Let's celebrate the victories of the past, and let's celebrate the victories of the present. This additional enlarging of your sanctuary. Your church has had some great pastors in the past, from the very first pastor in Reverend Goins, to Comer Johnson, to Reverend Terry, whose son is here today, he and his family, and Robert and Peggy Perry, who became missionaries in Africa, and W.S. Sessions, Bud Sessions, who has now passed on and is in heaven, Reverend T.A. Shirley, Charles Woods, these are some of the great pastors. But none of your past pastors have been better than your present pastor. Amen? You have a great pastor in Reverend Jimmy Ernest. He's a great preacher. He's a great shepherd. He visits. He's a man of God. He's a hard worker. You heard him talk about his long days and long nights. Don't you think it'd be appropriate this time to celebrate by giving a rising standing ovation to Pastor and Mrs. Ernest?
It won't be long
Maybe you're not ready for this. That I predict, Pastor, that it won't be long until you're going to, that this new enlarged sanctuary is going to be bursting at the seams. That's what the one translation was. Bursting at the seams. Would you like to see that happen? If you're excited about continued growth to fill this sanctuary, say amen.
Amen.
I feel it. I feel it. It's going to happen because God, as he promised Isaiah, that they needed, they're going to have to plan again to enlarge the tents. That same promise is to us today. Now the chapter in verse 1, or in that verse, the chapter opens with the admonition to sing. Verse 1 quote. Chapter 54, verse 1, says, break out into loud and joyful singing. Break out in loud and joyful singing. And as your Anniston church has built on additions, as you have enlarged your sanctuary, this is cause for celebration. It's a day to break out.